Greetings! Hello guys! In this video I'm going to talk about stability, how it works and how you can make walls around your base, what are your options. So let's get right into it. So what we can see is that most of the time new players, what they do is just foundation spam in front of their base. You have to understand and learn that stability doesn't work on foundations really well. It gave 100 stability, however if I destroy only one piece of foundation, your huge wall of China wall gonna just be destroyed. Let's check it out. So I only have to like destroy one foundation and then I got a hole where I could just enter your base. So please don't build like this. Okay, we got the other one. Players sometimes build like this because this one is just a little bit easier to just spam foundations. However, I don't advise to build something like this as well. If you're already building like this, just use walls on the side, because I'm going to show it to you again. Again, the whole row just fell down. If I would start bombing on the bottom, what we would see if this is a tunnel, there's a huge chance that some ceiling is gonna be destroyed. So what could happen is, for example, you have 3-4 doorways and then you have your base and you build exactly like this, that you foundation spend on top of each other. There's a high chance that I'm gonna destroy one of the ceilings meanwhile bombing, and then there's gonna be a big hole above it and probably I'll be able to enter your base from over here. So it's not a good technique still. And over here, if you see a wall like this, this huge wall, and it's fenced around properly, for example if they build on the bridge and you can just can't climb through, what you could do is the still the same thing, just make a hole over here and destroy one foundation and the whole column gonna be destroyed. What can we see over here? What to do with the drawbridge? Let's say we live on a bridge like this. What you can do is, if it's not properly fenced around, destroy the fences and go through. Or if they build foundations next to it, just start placing bombs over here or from the top, as I showed it in earlier videos. Start bombing from there and just destroy this foundation. And then you'll be able to come inside and skip the drawbridge, even open the drawbridge for your mates. Best case scenario, what you can see, which is I think really clever, is just blocking off with gate frames, the road. Line it up so it can be divided by 3, because they can place a gateway on 3 foundations. And of course, fence it around properly. A column without ceiling on the left side, and the column on the right side where we have everywhere ceiling. Over here doors, and on the left side at this block there's like no ceilings in between the walls, and over here we have everywhere ceiling. So what's gonna happen is that if I'm destroying a wall, I'm gonna only destroy a wall because the ceilings and the other walls are just holding each other. They're gonna still stick around. Meanwhile over here at this column we don't have any ceiling which could hold it, and the whole column would just collapse. So make sure you build it accordingly. Next one, what we have here? You can make a base under the water too with this method. Okay, alright. With this method, it won't collapse. Only if you have gateways. If you want to make a huge underwater base, in order to seal it fully on top, you will need pillars either way. So why not just build it from walls, let it be a little bit more expensive, but it won't collapse as much. As you can see over here, it didn't collapse at all. However, it's still easier to build underwater with gateways, but the stability would just fuck you up, because in the middle you need pillars either way. So also one thing is that if you have a ceiling and it has enough stability, you can place a wall, only one. But you can place it downwards. You have a pillar right like this, you place a ceiling on it, and you can only place one wall downwards. You can place as many as you want upwards, but you can only place one downwards. So let's talk about a little bit more of layer stacking. So, how does it done? So the foundation has 100k HP, however it is easy to destroy. As I showed earlier, only need to do is just destroy one foundation and then the hole would collapse. So how can you layer stack then without the stacking method? So you place two walls on each side of the foundation and then the wall is 140k altogether, and you can make it stand longer and you can block easier players. During raid time, if rebuild is allowed, it is really easy to block other people inside than just placing foundations, because what you can do is you can place pillars in between, and you can place, if there's like no ceiling, then you can place also foundation in between. But what I mean, I will show it later. We can sandwich. I like the sandwich method. With fence foundation, because fence foundation has bigger HP. So I highly advise if you decide to use this sandwich method, which basically consists of like putting everywhere around the foundation fence foundations, then use the fence foundations instead of just putting walls. I was talking about it earlier over here that you can block easier players if you have these wooden walls, if you place walls around. And the reason for that is you can block them with pillars actually. So right now I'm gonna show it to you guys is that if we have pillars over here, we won't be able to walk past them. And you might say, what the fuck, man? I've done it several times. I had like wall next to me and I managed to go around the pillar and do that. Yeah, it is true. You can do it. But you can only do it if the wall is facing outwards towards where you want to cross. So if you want to go through, you have to make sure that you cross it where the wall is placed outwards towards to you. Because if it's inwards, then you can't pass through. So we can just make some tricks with this. We can make one-way tunnels, like I'm going to show you over here in the middle. So what we can see is that over here we can walk around all the doorways. However, in the middle, what we can see is that we won't be able to. And all we need to do is just place one pillar down, and then the enemy is just pretty much fucked, because he has to destroy the pillar or one of the walls. So we can make one-way tunnels, and around them we can just reinforce with foundations, fence foundations, whatever we want to. I'm just giving you the tricks right now. And over here what we can see is the same thing. If the wall looks outwards towards to you, you can pass through. If it's inwards, you won't be able to. So altogether, what I wanted to say to you guys is, if you try to make layers upon layers without fence foundations, I prefer doing it with gates, but you decide however you do. Never ever make it with foundations like this what we have over here, because I can just destroy one foundation and everything gonna collapse. And it's actually the same if we would say, let's say we have this pillar and I just don't pay attention how I build and where's the last section of the pillar, and I would just elevate it over here to the sky. I don't know why not. The enemy would just come with a trebuchet, and actually he would hit the perfect foundation and the whole thing would collapse. So make sure you don't build the layers with foundations. I know the other method's more expensive because you need to put that, for example, two walls or something like that, and plus ceilings between them. That's already too much, I know, but make it happen like that. Also around drawbridges, never ever put foundations unless they have connection to the structure. Just make sure you find perfect technique what I showed to you guys. So thank you guys for watching. See you in the next one. Bye.
No sleep, no rest. Night crash, night wake. But first I stretch and I'll